Hello and good morning. I am Professor A.V. Brahmane. Today we are going to learn unit number 6. The name of the unit is Swarm Intelligence. Under this, we are going to learn Introduction to the Swarm Intelligence, Particle Swarm Optimization, and Colony Optimization. Friend, before going to start the actual content of this unit number 6, let me remind you the unit number 4. Unit number 4 was evolutionary computing. This evolutionary computing and swarm intelligence are related with each other. How they are related? So you keep in your mind that swarm intelligence is one of the component of evolutionary system. Likewise, there are genetic algorithm is the another component of evolutionary system or evolutionary computing. Talking about evolutionary computing, so there are different levels or different stages of this evolutionary computing. First stage is initialize the population. Second one is selection. Third one is crossover. Fourth one is mutation. Next one is evolution. And these levels or these stages are continue to form the generations. That is the job of evolutionary computing. And obvious that there are different methods for selections, there are different methods for mutations, crossovers, and there are different stopping conditions. So you can apply these stopping conditions to stop. So once you stop, your generation is created. Okay. And very important point in evolutionary system that there is a fitness function that is also called as objective function. So based on that fitness function, the best parents, or we can say the best candidate solution, is selected for next generation. So that is all about the evolutionary systems or evolutionary computing. Now talking about our today's chapter, that is swarm intelligence, why we required a new computing technique? Because the rapid development in the science and technology changes the world rapidly. And communication, transportation, industrial productions, administration, writing and bookkeeping, technological advances are some of the areas that change very rapidly. And because we are using the traditional systems, the traditional system is having some of the drawbacks, like a traditional system, I can give you the example, like a serial computer is there. Okay, serial computer is a traditional system. And with the help of this serial computer, we cannot able to complete our job very fastly. This is one of the point. Another point is that it is difficult to make a prediction using serial computing. And also, the tasks are not well organized in serial computers. So these are some of the drawbacks of these traditional techniques. Now, you can see there are some problems, hard problems. I can say it is a hard problems, like NP hard problems or action, reasoning, planning. NP hard problem, the example is a traveling salesman problem. The action response planning is the chess playing. Another example I can give you, the fuzzy problems, like intelligent human machine interaction, natural language understanding. These problems are hard. Another example that will give you the clear idea, like here in this picture, the Japanese piano robot is shown. The robot is playing the piano. And another picture shows you the trade at the stock exchange. So these are the problems which are hard problems. So it is hardly predictable and dynamic problems. So these problems are difficult to tackle with traditional system. This is our point. So traditional system is having a drawback, and this traditional system cannot handle these problems, hard problem, easily and effectively. So what we can do then? So we are having some alternatives, like a DNA based computing. Then the quantum computing is a widely and very focused and popular computing methodology, which is used nowadays in every applications. Biocomputing is there, and the biocomputing is nothing but the simulation of biological mechanism. Quantum computing is the quantum physical computation, and DNA based computing is the chemical computations. So we are related with this biocomputing. because our evolutionary system or evolutionary computing is inspired by nature. It is also called as it is a bio-inspired technique. Okay, so that's why there are bio-inspired algorithms. Many algorithms are there that are called as bio-inspired algorithms. So artificial neural network. ANN also plays the important role in this swarm intelligence, because whatever we are going to develop that is inspired by nature, and in nature the human brain comes. So human brain is having a various properties, like it is holistic, it is parallel, associative learning, redundancy, it is self-organized. So all these properties of the human brains are equally induced in computers or in machines. That's why it is called as a computational intelligence. Artificial neural network must have or must possess all the properties of this human brain. Okay. Now, just I mentioned the evolutionary algorithms. This slide will also clear you that there is a population of the solution, so which are having a fitness functions. So fitness function means which are having a quality which are already evolved and they are initialized. So we are selecting a best solution out of this population by using selection techniques, and after selection we are getting this four candidate solution where we can apply the reproduction. As I said, the reproduction is also called as crossover. And after cross, what we are going to do in crossover, that the characteristics of all these candidate solutions are interchanged or mixed with each other. The best characteristics are interchanged, crossover, and we form this next stage. So in this next stage, we use the mutation, and after mutation, we get the evolution, and this stage continue till we get the best candidate solution. So this is the evolutionary algorithm. Okay. And very important that the selection is having different methods. Reproduction, crossover is having different methods. Mutation is also having different methods. Evolution, and these stages are also continue till we apply the stopping conditions. Now you can see where these things are useful. What are the fields of application? Like robotic, artificial intelligence, process optimization, staff scheduling, telecommunication companies, and entertainment. These are some of the applications are listed here, but the list is very big where the swarm intelligence or these evolutionary systems are useful. Now, what are the limitations? See here, biology make compromises between different goals. Biology sometimes fails. Some natural mechanisms are not well understood, and well-defined problems can be solved by better means. Now, what is a swarm intelligence? The scientist named Bonabio in 1999, he tells that the emergent collective intelligence of groups of simple agents is nothing but the swarm intelligence. So you can see here, the emergent collective intelligence of a group of a simple agent is nothing but swarm intelligence. So he gives an example like grouping forging of a social insect, cooperative transportation, division of labor, nest building of a social insect, collective sorting and clustering. So here very important is that grouping forging and nest building of social insect. So in nature, we come across or we are observing various insects like ant, okay, or various birds are there, okay, fish. So how this ant or these insects are living? So how they are working in a group? That is called as group forging of a social insect, nest building of a social insect. So one of the very important application of our swarm intelligence as well as the evolutionary computing is the optimization. Okay, we use these techniques for optimization. Obvious that there are searching, heuristic searching, and the sorting are the other applications of this evolutionary computing. But optimization is the very important and first and prime objective of this swarm intelligence. So we are trying to understand and trying to learn how we can achieve the optimized solution by learning this group forging of social insect and nest building of social insect. So these are some our inspiration or motivation towards designing our optimization algorithm. So why is the SWAM intelligence interesting for information technology world? Because analogy in IT and social insect. Distributed system of interacting autonomous agent goal. Performance optimization and robustness. Self-organizing control and cooperation. That is decentralization. Division of labor and distributed task allocation, indirect interaction. These are some of the characteristics which we are finding or which we observed in this biological insect or this we observed it in nature, and same these characteristics are actually useful in IT industry, that we require to build application which is distributed, which are required to develop applications which give the performance optimization and which is robustness, which is self-organized, and where we divide the labor into different distributed tasks and we interact with each other. So these characteristics we found in nature, and that's why we require these characteristics in IT industry or in developing any application, scientific or commercial application. These characteristics are used in that application. That's why they are related with each other. So the SWAM intelligence, how they are interested for IT industry. So this is the answer. Okay. And then how can we design the SWAM intelligence system? So there are three step process. First one is the identification of analogy. So in a SWAM biology and IT systems, then understanding computer modeling of realistic SWAM biology, engineering model simplification and tuning for IT application. These are the three stage where we can, which we can use for developing the SI systems or SWAM intelligence systems. Now some of the observations. So now the next few slides will give you some idea that how this nature, how these biological insects or these biological systems are useful for SWAM intelligence. So you can see here the nest building in social WAPs, how the nests are built by these WAPs. Then group defense in honeybees. Then ants. So why are ants interesting? Because ants solve the complex task by simple local means. Ant productivity is better than some of their single activity. Ant are grandmaster in search and exploitations. Which mechanisms are important? Cooperation and division of labor. Adaptive task allocation, work stimulation by cultivation phenomena. So what are their principal mechanism of natural organization? So you can see self-organization is the very important characteristics of this biological insects or this ant, for example. Okay, self-organization. So self-organization is a set of dynamical mechanism whereby structure appear at the global level of system from interaction of its lower level components. So this is very important characteristics of any SWAM intelligence application. So it must be, or it requires to be a self-organized system. Okay. And then the four bases of self-organizations are positive feedback, that is called as amplification, negative feedback, that is for counterbalance and stabilization, then amplification of fluctuation, that is randomness, errors, random walks, and next one is multiple interactions. So here one example is shown that will give you the idea that ant foraging. So cooperative search by pheromone trails. So here the nest of the ant is shown and the food is here. So ant is travel in search of the food. And now you can observe how they are traveling and how they are getting their foods. So you can see they are traveling and coming back to their nest. Again, they are traveling. Now the number of ants are increased. And without overlapping, without disturbing other ants, effectively, efficiently, and clearly, accurately, so the ant is getting their foods and they are coming back to their nests. So this is the characteristics, self-organization. these characteristics of this ant that we need to adopt for developing our swarm intelligence or our optimized algorithms. So characteristics of self-organized systems: structure emerging from homogeneous startup state, multi-stability coexistence of many stable states, state transitions with dramatical change of the system behavior. And now you can see this is the flowchart for self-organization in Terminite simulation. This self-organization in Terminite simulation, and you can see the self-organization in honeybee nest building, how they are maintaining their self-organization for developing their nest. And self-organization in honeybee nest building, the queen moves randomly over the comb. So this slide, it will tell us that how the honeybees are working efficiently, effectively for building their nest. Stages are shown here. And again, this figure can give you the idea that how slowly and steadily they are developing their nest. Okay, the stigmary is there. The characteristic of this stigmary, this is also the very daily example that we are observing everywhere, that how they are building their nest. Okay, this picture can show you the stigmary in Terminite nest building. Okay, so this is the summary, and this will tell us that motivation and methods in biological inspired IT. Okay, and then we learn two principles in swarm intelligence. First one is the self-organization, and second one is the stigmary simulation by work. So I hope that by learning this, you are able to understand what do you mean by swarm intelligence, and how these are important for developing any scientific and commercial application. This is not only sufficient, we require some algorithms of this swarm intelligence. So very soon we are going to learn the techniques like algorithms like particle swarm optimization and ant colony optimization. These are the part of your syllabus. Thank you very much.